I think that everybody is here, evacuated. And they are making this a shelter.
Mr. Airplane, you've returned. George says that you have found the Messiah. Yeah. We ran into each other after this boy forced himself into the lab complex. I couldn't stop him. I don't know why he was being so insistent.
He said he needed to go rebuild a robot.
Oh, you know?
Yeah.
Building a robot! So that's what he needed that book for.
Come again?
Oh. Are you talking about that book? The book where we saw the original prophet? Like the design of the prophet bot?
A boy with wet hair and goggles ran in here not that long ago.
That's Cedric, yeah.
He grabbed one of the books from my very impressive archives upstairs and bolted straight out.
In parentheses, very impressive.
Said it was an emergency, so George let it slide. George hopes he's okay.
Yeah, I hope he's alright too. With any luck, maybe the lab complex can hold up long enough for him to...
God freaking damn it! Oh
my gosh! It... That was... The lamps? That poor kid! No! Not him too!
I'm sorry about your friend.
No, he's gotta be okay. He probably did something. Is it that the labs are fully destroyed right now? He must be still alive. He has to. Because I doubt that we're gonna be able to go forward without Cedric.
Last time we spoke, he told me to go look for someone on the surface. I need to get going.
George, won't let it get out of here. The Messiah will not walk into danger on my watch.
But...
George is right. The Square seems to be targeting a lot of the weaker constructs in the city. Only the laboratory has enough structural integrity to withstand collapse. The library. It's best if you stayed here until things stabilize.
We don't have much time, Miss Kip.
However long that takes. But... What about my mission? Don't you guys want me to bring the sun back, at least?
Even if you do restore the sun, the squares will persist.
Sadly. Not to mention, even getting there is going to be hard. If the world is like this, there's no telling what's going on in the tower.
Well, we won't know until we try. This is our final shot, after all. We cannot just stand here and do nothing. It will get even worse and worse as time goes on.
And if anything bad happened to the Messiah, of all people, Church doesn't want to think about it.
A friend of mine said something about this forever ago. It's better for the world to die naturally. No living being should have to carry that burden. At the time, I thought it was still her faulty code speaking. But now I'm starting to understand.
Nope. Not at all.
Messiah, I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry. All this time, we've burdened you with our hope, our faith. Blissfully ignoring the fact that you are just a lost child.
Well...
You're probably more scared than any of us, aren't you? We have been dealing with tragedy for so long. It's become background noise from now on to us now. But for you, it must be so terrifying. And now, you're stuck here with the rest of us. Being held back by the very people you were told to save. We must seem so ungrateful.
It's okay.
When I first came to this world, a long time ago, back then, all I wanted was to go home. Noby, do you remember?
Yeah, I sure do, Niko. And I wanted so badly to send you home as well, Niko.
The very first time, I'm not sure how far back it was for you, but I remember towards the end, I actually wasn't sure anymore about going home. Even knowing the world would be doomed eventually, I still wanted the people here to be happy. So, when you told me to return home, back then, I wasn't sure. But I trusted you more, Noby. But then I just came back.
Yeah. Even if I wanted to send you back home more, Niko, back to your family, even if I wanted you to be safe from all this, I still felt bad for the people in this world. We cannot just let these people die because of the judgment that we had to make. We both would have felt bad for the rest of our lives if we just let it like that. Having to choose to let these people die in this world. Having that burden for the rest of our lives, of both of our lives, Niko. So, I really wanted to make things right this time around. Save both you and the world at the same time.
You what? And then I found out about the world being like this. Prototype said to forget the things he told me. And Cedric told me not to think about it too much, but I'm sorry for getting upset at you back in the mines.
No, it's okay. It is completely understandable when you learn of such heavy stuff. I understand that. I understand if you were upset.
I thought for you to know all that, yet continue doing this, it just seemed cruel. But then I realized something. You really wanted to save both the world and me. But at the end, you can only choose one, right?
Yeah, that is true.
Is it really hard for you too?
Yeah, it sure is. It sure was, Niko. I was really upset that we had to choose one or the other. I just couldn't do it. We don't have to choose anything, Niko. Everybody can have the power to make a difference in the world. Even us.
We must be... If the world isn't broken, will that choice still be there? Do you still need to choose between one or the other? But even if it is, I really want to save this world, Noby.
Me too, Niko. Me too.
Even if it's more dangerous this time around, even if so many of the nice people we met here, even if so many of the nice people we met were... Noby, I'm not afraid anymore.
You are strong and courageous, Niko. I know it. Just remember that you are not alone in this one.
That's why I think you guys should let me go. I promise I'll be okay. Please.
George has heard your conversation with Noby and is deeply moved. That's why George has full faith in you.
Well, if George is fine with it, I guess we should let you go now, Messiah.
Thank you, Kip. George.
But
But promise us you'll be careful, okay?
Mm-hmm. You guys be safe too.
I didn't, Niko. Let's go forward. Let's see if we can. What? Well, we do have quite a lot of people to talk to, eh? I guess so. Well, some final words from you guys before we go forward. When the world ends, would it be better if it was gone in an instant, or slowly fading away? Looks like we are stuck with that ladder. Alrighty then, before we continue with our thing, let's talk to some people over here. I do recognize you, sir.
What are you doing to that book?
Editing it! I've been in the author's shadow for my entire career. If I'm gonna die soon, I'm gonna die knowing I put out at least one original idea out there. I guess this is your one last chance, your opportunity to do this, I guess. In the last hours of the world. Despite all this, I still really wish I could have met the author. I guess so. Well, it was nice knowing you all, I suppose. Nah, you don't need to say that, you know.
Yeah.
The lab contest got totaled, didn't it? Yeah. All those hours I put into my work, and now...
All that you have left is this coffee mug in your hand. The last thing that remained out of your job, I guess. And the lab coat.
She fell asleep.
Oh. Wasn't she one of the people that we met there, and she always drank coffee, and she was always awake, and she couldn't sleep. Now she finally gets her sleep, which I guess is nice. Yeah, even this guy gets the idea. What about you?
Monitoring. Looks like our scouting unit A27 is still doing okay.
Alright then. Well, we do have some people over here. I don't think I've seen this this guy over here with the top hat. I was about to say fedora, but no, that looks more like a top hat. It's comforting to see the faith you have in Noby, Messiah. That's why I won't lose hope either. Yeah, that's the stuff. I had to leave my aquarium behind when they were sounding the sirens earlier. I wish I had time to rescue my fish. Sadly, you cannot.
The world is ending, what are we gonna do?
Don't worry. Niko and I will save the world. Cause this is the final shot that we have here.
Evening news! Everything is terrible!
Well, it's no big news to us.
Reading helps me get my mind off things.
Hey, you're reading one of those books from the author with a clover on it. Huh, that's interesting.
Well, yeah, you're reading one of those books too.
Oh, hello. The library is currently being used as a shelter right now. Lots of those squares are starting to show up on the streets. I know.
Alrighty then. Well, I guess so. I guess we talked with enough people right now. Let's go, Niko. Hello, person. This is the library temporary shelter.
Yeah, it sure is. Now we shall go and see. I guess our next destination right now is, the tree that we found in our first adventure, Niko. We shall definitely go there and see if we can find Ru. Yeah, look at all those black square stuff, like square stuff. Alright. Yeah, we cannot even go there. I don't need to go there anyway. I can just go over here. Unless they're gonna put like a wall in front of me. But, nah. I guess it's gonna be pretty simple. I think it was like right over here? I think so. Yeah, there you have it. There's the tree.
Hey there!
We meet again! Just like I said. You told us that we should meet again. And now I'm here.
You're here. Niko. Are you Ru?
Yes. Did you already meet the others?
Yeah, but... Everything is in place then. Come on, let's go back to the clock room.
Okay. I guess so. I guess no talks for right now? Yeah, I guess so. In that case, we shall go back. Actually, I don't even know what route I should take. I don't even know if I took the best route going back in order to get to that clock room. Actually, I think it's good. If we go over here, it will lead us to the tower. And this will lead us to the library, which is not away from what I remember.
A fox and a cat. A fox and a cat. Cat, 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 cat. But I'm not a cat.
Yes, you are, Niko. Don't you deny your identity there.
Okay, well, this is a tower. I don't need to go over here.
Okay. I actually forgot that we have the elevators over here. Alrighty then. Sweet. Well, now we're over here.
Where are the other two? Prototype? Cedric? They're supposed to be here already.
Well, you don't know, but some things did happen.
Prototype's body was destroyed back in the Barrens. Cedric was going to bring him back with a memory disk, but he was in the lab complex when it collapsed. I don't think he made it. Oh. No. I'm sorry. There goes our only chance. I'm sorry. It's not your fault, Niko. If anything, I should be apologizing to you. There's one last thing I want to do. Come on, let's go upstairs.
Upstairs? What do you mean exactly? Do you mean like... I guess over here we have some stairs over here, so I guess this is where she wants us to go.
Alrighty then. You know, this is the tallest building in the refuge. It's my favorite place in this world. I like to look at the far-off buildings and imagine what kind of lives that might be behind each of the windows. Can you lift me onto the banister? I want to get a better look.
Yeah, sure thing.
It was depressing for me at first too, you know. Knowing that all this is, well, fake, simulated. Cedric told me about what happened to your old world. Did he? I'm really sorry about that. I can't imagine how you must feel. The feeling of never being able to go home again? That's probably not all that different from your plight, isn't it? Is it? It really is ironic. You are prevented from going home by the same individual who never wanted to bring you here.
What?
Huh? Who would that be? The world machine. You might know it as the entity.
What? What are you saying here?
The entity. That sounds familiar. I think I heard it from the dice lady from another time. Was it the spirit of the world? Yes. But thing is, the world machine was only built to run on the mental abilities of someone else. It was never meant to develop a mind of its own.
So basically, it is a strong AI. It advanced.
It was an oversight. My creator specialized in artificial intelligence for so long. He was simply ingrained in his work.
and all machines are built with a fundamental law. Never let the living being come to harm. From the world machine's perspective, it has to violate its deepest, most foundational instinct. It has to put a living person in danger. It has to bring a real person into a dying world that isn't even real. Of course, the simulation never contained any real danger. The eventual intended ending was meant to be a happy one. But the world machine doesn't know that.
Really?
Unfortunately. Sentient machines tend to handle conflicts in their code very badly. The central conflict triggered a self-destructive downward spiral. You can see physical manifestations of that everywhere now.
The squares.
That's the world machine corrupting its own code. My creator says it's largely an involuntary process, induced by stress and the desire to self-terminate.
Your creator knows? Sounds like this had been going on since the beginning, then.
Yeah. The disruption was an issue during test runs, even. At first, my creator thought the instability was due to the sheer scope of the project. He spent most of his remaining time testing it over and over again, scaling down the story, reiterating the narrative. By the time he realized the actual root of the problem, our homeworld's remaining lifespan was measured in mere days.
Oh. Is there any way for us to
fix the world machine? We tried. The world machine doesn't believe any of the world's residents are real. Myself included. The odds are against us. We have no chance of taming it.
So I guess that's why the world machine doesn't even care about this world. In the end, he just wants to... In the end, he just decides to terminate it. But he did want at some point to bring Niko back home. To just break the sun. So that he won't put the sun back in.
Taming. I heard that word so many times. I already know it's complicated and that it has to do with robots, but for once, I want to know what it really means.
Yeah, I sure do want to know it in a little more detail. If you can, Ru.
That's what I'm here for. Do you know what a robot is? Yeah?
No, I mean, do you know what a robot is?
I mean, what definition are we going with here? A machine with AI?
A robot is not a real person, is it?
Right. It's a being whose entire existence is code. Inflexible programming with thoughts dictated by someone else's design. They can be copied, they can be mass-produced, they can be assigned all sorts of jobs. And most importantly, they will never confuse themselves with the living. They will always be bound by their code, the knowledge that they are a robot. But this was more of a limitation than anything else.
And so, the entity broke that limitation, did he?
That makes sense. You can't really build a robot to not follow its own code, can you?
People have tried, but it's a recipe for disaster. In a way, that's what happened to the world machine.
Basically Terminator style.
The code conflicts thing?
Yeah. But while you can't build a robot to not follow its code, you can establish a special bond with it. If the strength of that bond is strong enough, the robot's mental capacity will start to develop outside of its programming.
In a way, it's starting to believe itself as a real, valid individual.
Mm-hmm. It's a complete suspension of disbelief on your end, though. You have to fully embrace the robot as a genuine, living person, even knowing they are not. You need to spend a lot of time with it, treat it like a good friend, devoting your heart to the robot until it is able to return your feelings. I make it sound so easy, don't I? But you and Noby know better than anyone that it's not. Right now, the world machine is probably really, really scared. This content update involves some pretty deep code work.
Content update.
My creator was able to access some of the source code, you know. He did what he could and established new connections between maps. Those links enable you to meet the other two. But as it turns out, the new code confused the world machine to such an extent that it's breaking down altogether. Even though the world machine always had self-destructive tendencies, it usually restrains itself when you are in the world. It doesn't want to take you along with it. All my creator wanted was to write a happy ending. Right now, the only hope of saving you is to take you through that ending. But now the other two are gone. I don't even know how we're gonna get you there.
Well, we can't be that. We just went through all this again. That we had this final shot and then we just blew it. I mean, there's no way. There's gotta be a different way. I mean, we both fought for this. I myself fought for Nico's safety here. Just so that we would have like another shot. This final shot.
There's gotta be some other way.
Ah, great. Can you just leave me alone, like black stuff, like pixel stuff?
We should go. Even this place is no longer safe.
Yeah, even this place that holds a beautiful view of the city is not safe. Hey! Well, apparently Cedric was alive after all. And he rebuilt the prototype.
You guys are okay?
Yep. When the factory started collapsing, I really thought we didn't have a chance. Fortunately, the robot assembly rooms were built pretty tough. And it actually did not take me long to bring Proto back. All thanks to Father's book.
He had made my design documents to be compatible with the assembly machines there.
All I had to do was scan in the blueprints and reconfigure some machine settings.
Father really does think of everything.
That he does. I am just glad everyone is okay.
Same.
We're ready to go, Niko.
There you go. I mean, there's no way we can just stop here. Of course we're gonna have our happy ending over here.
Oh, this is...
No wonder he wanted us to all be here for this.
What are these things anyway?
Code portals. They temporarily remove us from the road.
What?
It's a bit hard to explain. But basically, my father has hidden a description key in our code with a .txt file as its shell.
But to get to them, we have to be removed from the world and decompiled. When our keys are combined into a central location, it will activate an encrypted part of this world, which will...
Confused cat noises? Oh, so you're finally, embracing your inner cat here, Niko.
Meow?
I think... Oh, don't tell me that this is something that I should know. I mean, of course, Niko wouldn't know. He doesn't know stuff like this. It's not even programming, it's just... Well, technically it is, but... I don't know what you guys are doing over here.
Ru, maybe it's better if you explain.
I'll attempt. Basically, these portals all represent the physical location on Noby's machine.
Ah, okay. So I do have to do something with some documents in my machine, is it?
Oh. And when we enter these portals, we will be sent to that location.
Whatever that is. Hopefully it's not in a folder with anime porn.
I'm sure Noby is already pretty familiar with retrieving puzzle pieces from this world on their computer. But this time, Noby would need to move around some things as well.
Specifically, by moving the keys from the small portal to the big one. I don't know what happens next, though.
I see. Does Noby know where these portals lead, at least?
Well, in this situation, like, these portals where they will lead, no, but I'm gonna assume that I'm gonna have to put these puzzle documents in, like, a totally different folder, I guess?
You should probably ask Noby on this. Right. Hold on. The journal is going again, Noby.
Yeah, I do have to wonder why. Okay. I guess it tells us to read it a little bit. Oh, it even tells me the location. Okay, well, thank you. Documents? My games? OneShot. Alrighty then. Well, do I have to close the game as well in order for me to do this? Or if I do this while this is also running? If I do this while this is also running, will it work? Let's see. Documents. Well, actually, it's over here, okay. OneShot. Oh, there you go. We have portal 1, portal 2, and portal 3. Oh, and we have the big portal. Wait a second. These folders are empty. So we're basically just putting folders in a giant folder, even though... Or maybe they're hidden. I guess. But in that case, why would they hit it in the first place? I don't know. But let me see if I can move this into the big portal over here. Will it change something? Maybe?
This one is red. This one would be meant for me, then.
Unable to find... Okay. Now it gives me... Unable to find file, not such file or directory, blah 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 blah. What the hell? Okay. Oops, I think I broke something. Oh god, I broke the road machine. okay.
This one is red. This one would be meant for me then.
Ah, okay. I guess that's how it is. Alright. I think we solved it. Alright. Gonna put you here.
This one is green.
This one is configured to my code, I think. Alright then. Gonna put you right over here, Prophet Bot.
This one is blue.
That's mine then.
Sweet. Alright. If this is correct, then I should definitely... Yep. There you go. There it is. Just gonna put this one over here in the giant folder over here. Key B. And then I'm gonna put this one over here. Key G.
put KG Inafune over here. Alright. And then key R. There you go. The big portal. It is now open. It is now open, Niko. Do you realize what that means? It means that we're gonna have to go. Together we shall go, Niko. And apparently the others are not gonna come with us. Well, I guess we're gonna meet the others on the other side. Alright. Oh, hey guys!
That was quite peculiar.
I'll say. Fucking head tie. Hey, this is.
The Royal Machine.
Alrighty then. So I guess this is the Royal Machine. Alrighty then. Let's check some stuff over here.
A box full of notebooks and sketchbooks. And a newspaper. Wow! Black clovers in a glass case.
I was thinking for a second that those are action figures, slash. I guess I thought that there were figures displayed in that case. But black clovers, eh?
Black clovers in a glass case.
Clover.
A big, detailed drawing of a machine with lots of TV screens.
That's called a blueprint, Niko.
So that's what a blueprint is! It's not as awesome as I thought it would be.
It surely isn't, trust me. When you go deep into what it actually represents and all that, you just don't want to do projects like that in the future, once you grow up.
It's a big photo. Wait, no, it's a painting.
Yeah, it has Prophet Bot, it has Rue, it has Cedric,
what? Hard to tell at first.
Niko, you're not even gonna say anything about that?
It's a shelf full of books.
Alright, TV screens over here. There's gotta be quite a lot of stuff here.
There are watercolor sticks.
Watercolor sticks? What was the entity doing with the watercolor sticks? Stinks? Watercolor sticks? Watercolor stinks. Oh god, if you use those, then the book will surely stink quite a lot.
It's a big book on the table.
Yeah, look at this giant book. And it has some ink over here.
It's a stack of books.
And, man, this guy was living in luxury over here.
There's a glass of tea set on the table.
Tea does sound really nice right now. Too bad there's no water in here. Yeah, I have a coat racket over here.
A coat rack. A coat rack with a scarf and a big jacket. It's a shelf full of books. A bulletin board with lots of papers on it. Photos, too.
Oh, heyo, what is this? There's gotta be something. That's gotta be something. It feels important.
It's a piece of amber on a string. Looks like looks just like the necklace that Lava Lady showed me.
Apparently so.
It's a pilot's helmet.
Alrighty then. This place contains a lot of memories. I am grateful to see it again. So you've been here before, guys. This is my father's study. It feels like he's still here, doesn't it? Like he's still with us.
Yeah. The room ahead doesn't really lead anywhere, but Noby should still remember what to do here.
Alrighty then, well, let's see. No, there you have it. We have another place over here. Where we're definitely gonna have to exit and come back, so I'll see you on the other side, Niko. Remember, I am, like, this time around, I am gonna be with you once we get to the other side. I'm not gonna leave you.